In today's video, I will go through my daily farm routine, like how I decide if I think it's worth to farm that day and what to actually farm. I've been getting a lot of questions about farming, especially in videos where I cover gear sets or exotics and all that. So I think this might help a lot of you guys out there. So if that sounds interesting, then let's get started. So I mean, the first thing you want to figure out is like, what do you actually want to farm? When you know what you want to farm, then you want to take a look at the loot target map, which you can toggle by pressing this button right here. Something I do every day is to go to the Division subreddit. They actually post a daily thread every day that shows the target loot map. So even if I'm not at the PC, I can just quickly see how the loot target map looks like. So it resets 8 p.m. CET. So you could translate that to your own time zone, but that's basically when the map resets. So I head to Reddit, I check the loot target map, and yeah, knowing whatever loot I'm going for, that will decide what I do that day. So let's say today I want to farm Fox Prayers and Contractor Gloves, so that would be Overlord and Petrov. So today I wouldn't actually say it would be that good of a day to farm those. So how do you know if it's a good day to farm those though? So I'm gonna tell you the best ways to farm in my opinion. So starting off with missions, I don't think there's that many missions that are that good. However, though, there is a few missions that, in my opinion, stands out. And one of them is Lincoln Memorial. Because this one right here have 4 bosses. And it's a pretty fast one to run, too. So as you can see, there are 4 bosses. So that's probably the best mission, in my opinion. Then we also do have Camp White Oak, which I think is a decent mission when you can play it on Invaded. It got a lot of bosses as well. If it's not invaded, it's not as good. So right now it's only 2 bosses. So, but when it's invaded, I think it's worth to do. Then another one that's all right is Bank Headquarters. Because you have 1 boss real early in the mission. So if you only want to farm 1 boss, you could do Bank Headquarters and just reset it though. But in terms of mission, I think Lincoln is the one you mainly want to look at. So today, if you're looking for Hillagard, like Point Man, perfect to do Lincoln. Then other than that, what I look at a lot as well is, of course, Dark Zone. Because Dark Zone is pretty fast to farm. Like, sure, I understand a lot of you guys don't like Dark Zone, but I personally do. And Dark Zone is pretty easy in terms of NPCs. Pretty fast to farm. And yeah, you get, like, challenging rewards, right? And yeah, super fast to do. So if you do like Dark Zone, or something to keep in mind with Dark Zone is that there is a few Dark Zone exclusive items. So the named items, for example, are the Hollow Man mask, which is like best in slot kind of for masks. You have the Gift, which is a perfect Vigilance Providence backpack. And you have Orbit, which is a perfect finisher pistol. And of course, also the exotic LMG Pestilence. So whenever you have mask, backpack, or Providence, or pistols, or LMGs in Dark Zone, that would be the perfect opportunity to go there and farm for those. Like everything basically revolves around loot target, if you want to do it super efficient. And talking about Dark Zone 2, if your zone is invaded as well, you want to definitely do it. Because when it's invaded, you get more experience from the landmarks, and it's a lot of experience if you farm Dark Zone a lot when it's invaded. Other than that, you also do have the open world, of course. And something to keep in mind of now, when we have the seasonal manhunt, so the zones right here that have the manhunt missions, you can actually reset them by going to manhunt and then just reactivate the manhunt, and that will reset those zones. Which means that you can actually farm those control points and reset them. However though, you don't want to do this if you haven't completed the manhunt, of course. But something else is that on Tuesday, when 8.5 comes, and this video is probably going to be released on Tuesday, then we should be able to reset the control points manually, so this shouldn't matter. As of recording this, that is not a thing right now, so hopefully that works. If it didn't though, you can keep this in mind. Other than that, if that didn't get in 8.5 or it's not working, you shouldn't worry though, because even let's say like a zone that can't be resetted right now. Let's take this zone right here for masks. Even if you can't reset the control points, just farming the activities right here that are tied to the control points, it's a really good way to do it as well. Because as long as you don't capture the control points, these side activities will continuously spawn. So you could just farm those all the time. I think it's worth to note as well that if there's any faction or mission that drops an exotic, you want to try to have the loot target for that said exotic when you do it. Because the loot target will increase the chance to get the exotic. However though, this doesn't work with the year 2 exotics as far as I heard. And talking about exotics as well, if you have gotten the exotic at level 30, you don't have to do the quest or the special thing for it in Warlords. Which means that you can farm anywhere for the exotic. Let's say you want Nemesis, you can just go and do snipers right here and it have a chance to drop. Same with like any other exotic except tier 2 ones and the Eagle Bear. The Eagle Bear is raid only from normal. But I think that covers everything I wanted to talk about. For a lot of you guys, you probably already knew this, but I get this question all the time. So I thought I would just cover it in a video. And I thought today was a pretty good timing as well. But if there was anything I forgot to mention, please put that in the comment and I will make sure that other people can see it as well. But I hope you guys found this video useful, and if you are interested in more Division 2 videos, then make sure to hit that subscribe button. See you guys in the next one.